programmer to robot and robot to robot digital data transfer protocols.
So he knows better than anyone how the central hub works. Does that mean Petrov could actually fool the hub? Then why did Dr. Sechenov trust these protocols to a single guy?
It's temporary. After the launch of Collective 2.0, digital communication channels will be rendered useless and irrelevant. Everything will be transmitted via neuropolymer wave emission. Binary code will be left in the dustbin of history.
And so will programmers. No wonder Petrov is so pissed. He wants to fuck shit up while he still can.
In broad strokes, although I suspect that Petrov has other motives.
He's a traitor to the motherland. Fuck his motives. How long do we have to stop him?
Hacking Collective Central Hub is a very difficult task. Even with the right communication equipment, Petrov will need considerable time to do it.
So where can he find that kind of equipment, other than the Science Center?
Only aboard the Flying Chelome Complex.
And nowhere else? That's great. Your goose is cooked now, Petrov, you traitorous dickhead. Another dungeon.
This is the testing ground, Major. There should be weapons here.
Testing ground, dungeon, same difference. Let's find the stuff and get moving.
Fading data.
Thank you.
The dreams and aspirations of Facility 3826's scientists know no bounds. The daring Soviet scholars want to know, how can I make a Soviet citizen's life in space as comfortable as possible? What conditions are key to making their stay outside of the Earth's atmosphere indistinguishable from what they're used to? Here at Testing Ground 6, you can observe one such experiment. Will it be possible for future space-faring generations to watch movies in zero gravity? The answer is, naturally, for the Soviet citizen, nothing is impossible.
Is that?
A special transporter for valuable cargo, or Comrade Lutyagin, according to the employee's facetious name for it.
Valuable cargo is all well and good, but why is it stuck there like that?
Its base features a prototype of a perpetual motion engine that forces the...
Boring. Give me the short version.
Once released, it moves quickly between certain set points.
It's dead still. Looks like your perpetual motion engine is busted.
This turbine serves both as a hype facility for teams of WSP-9s and as an actuator for the generator that supplies power to the testing ground's mechanical staff.
That's not what I had in mind.
Testing Ground 6's planning department is responsible for 1. Obtaining and supporting solutions for the construction of future testing workshops. 2. Producing construction designs for the reconstruction, repair, and construction of new buildings. 3. Producing design specifications and estimates for construction jobs. And 4. Preparing planning-related statements of work.
Fuck.
not bad.
It will get better, Comrade Major.
Was that a joke? At whose expense? Let's get going.